you wanna hustle. Make it light up your life like pepper light like this. Cause I come along. But I'm a quitter being in a rut. Like you should have them kids time fly a bag of bat. And who said Russia not a being a game come against side and I am a man. None of them don't dip on me level. Hombre not even I know how I do. I do it like Jordan and show me that shock. And that's how it's happening. You don't know when but I know today, I know tomorrow. I know today, I know tomorrow. Bust it in a
better tomorrow. For them now jam like no jam. I condemn now it's for program. You know she say you should have sent some more man. For shooter they jam come
man. Yeah, man.
Some guy in that town is them roll like number. They start to pop up send jeans roll up.
Ešeše.
Mutaj!
Tu še obrat. Teraz.
He sound like when dog a give birth. You ever listen to a monkey a fight for scraps?
Tu še obrat.
Jesus Christ. I ain't your joke, you know. It look like he just passed him training and film karate test, you know. You know some guess and hype. Look on him pose! The struggle is real! Go down! Sewage! Mosquito flying out here! Bumbo clot! Me check say them a ballerina and by the time me quinta dirty sewage water they in a sewage go down. Struggle is real.
I swear on my fucking life, who's been to my house on Saturday and stolen my fucking £185 Gucci belt. When I fucking catch you all, bruv, I swear on my life I'm gonna bang every single one of you that was in my house on Saturday, bruv. This ain't a joke thing, bruv. There's a £185 fucking pound fucking Gucci belt that everyone thinks they can steal from my house, bruv. Are you fucking mad? Watch, bruv. I swear on my life, bruv. People still think they can steal from my house, bruv. You think you can steal my Oyster cards, my bank card, and now my fucking £185 Gucci belt, bruv. I swear on my life, I'm gonna bang every single person that was in my house, bruv, on Saturday, bruv. I swear on my life, I'm gonna bang every single cunt that was in my fucking house on Saturday, stealing my £185 Gucci belt, yeah? You think you're fucking bad? You think you're fucking bad? Watch. All my life, bruv, I'm gonna fucking stab every single one of you. Not even stab you, bruv. I'm gonna stab all over your fucking faces, bruv. I swear on my life, bruv. You think you can steal off me, bruv? You think you can steal off me, mate? Watch, bruv. All the people that were in my house on Saturday night and stole my Gucci, my fucking 2 Oyster cards, now my bank card, and now this, and my mate Peanuts' Oyster card. Watch, bruv. I swear on my life, bruv. I swear on my life, I'm gonna bang every single one of you in your faces and stamp all over your fucking heads, bruv. You think you can steal off me, bruv? All my days, bruv. You just stole off the wrong fucking person. I swear on my life, you stole off the wrong fucking person, mate. Watch what I'm gonna do, bruv. I swear I'll stamp on every single one of your heads, bruv. You think you can stamp? You think you can actually fucking steal off me, bruv? All my days. I swear on my life, bruv. That's a £185 Gucci belt that I've had for 5 years, bruv. For five fucking years. Bruv. For 5 fucking years, and you fucking not think you can fucking steal from my house, bruv? All my days, bruv. All my days. All my days. I'm so fucking angry right now, bruv, that my fucking £185 Gucci belt is gone from my house. I've had for 5 years, bruv, and someone steals it from my house. I'm so fucking mad, bruv. Yeah, oh, I'm so fucking mad. I'm so fucking mad. I'm so fucking mad, bruv.
Now look after her, baby.
I swear in my life, bruv. I'm literally so fucking angry, bruv, that people think they could come to my house and steal off me, you little tramps. You little tramps. Look at you, you tramps. I swear, you are all tramps. You're tramps. Tramps, tramps, tramps. Fucking little tramps.
Calm down, mate. Calm down, mate. Calm down, mate. Every estate in the UK has one of those. The struggle is real.
Papa, na kabi ni kila iyo niya. Fuck.
I want to some of them blood clad people here. You mean say you are force in a war with the baby in your hand? There is this stage where you gonna fight with the baby in your hand? I fling the and drop your baby like that. I don't even look on the baby. Supposed to be stepping there, baby. That step on the baby on the ground. As somebody else, if you come pick up your baby, instantly you pick me drop. You know, try push your somebody and move your pick. No, the struggle is real.
Some heart and kidney more after me and me now brains, you know, but me can't get that right now, you know. Right now the devil ignorant, you know. Right now it's some your flesh.
Indie style.
Right now it's Bill style, you know.
Oh yeah.
Kill them with a pussy smile, you know.
Oh yeah. Indie style, you know.
Me must you throat me get more blood than a vampire. Oh,
no, no.
Your heart and my breath fast and your liver a go with honey and some blood clot lunch I have. And don't forget your brain become a blood clot in a I have. Because what a hillbilly style, hillbilly style. Kill them with a pretty smile. Come back to your heart more. Liver, lungs, brain.
Yeah.
Kidney, liver!
Alright, don't know.
No!
What if you can stop it?
But people, what the bumbo clad them big old, them look mongrel, yeah? Want them look dog shit of people? Want them look waste of space, yeah? Want them look waste man, de? I want them look shit of the people? You know, say, them get the blood clad system bad name. Ain't fuck if Salam Melapaisen and kill him to blood clad. And mongrel, what I'm doing, why everything are evil? Evil, you me I say? You know, me feel say more time police check them though. When them come with them bag of fucker, police check them about they want them people out, or they want them kidney and them brain, but blood clot evil. Cause you see, anytime, any day, any day, the police them find somebody with their organ missing and cut out, and them out, and if you have them video, you have to check them like a blood clot while mongrel, yeah. They like a wild animal, yeah. Look how the blood clot boy stung the people and named the raw chicken. Look how the little shit toss stung the and named the raw chicken and I talk about evil. But he want brain and heart and liver chink and get none for go eat ya now. Look what blood clot we have in our society. So the place become better. Before the man go find some constructive good for go do, go find some farmer work for go do, then sit down a blood clot daytime. Look how his son act. In that no look like he pussy did they are working up. I talk about them and brain and watch them for me and did they and name raw chicken. I try to prove a point for the camera. How do they idiot the people? Community when come from what? You no can't see them and talk to them talk so sense not them mongrel head. You can't use a big sledgehammer and one nail and drill so sense not them blood clot head. Police one time when you see them waste of space and put up video like this and if you hold on to the video them. One time when you see people missing with their organ and go look for blood clot them. I go ask them old people and cut out and yam out their organ. Because them and yam raw meat. Anything possible. And when they start feed pan blood clot raw meat, then we have a taste raw meat. Enough of them are vampire and cannibal for blood clot too. Enough of them are cannibal but hillbilly style. Because you see it, all they love to do are watch and follow other blood clot country where other people do. So then we start yam people along the una fi keep a eye upon every man girl one time listen and expose themselves like this. It's sure is real to bumbuck lad. Look pan the piece of shit too. It chicken shed us choke you. Happy Sunday, beautiful people. How are you guys doing? Hold on, here's the leave my show. Hold on. Yeah, good little camera, look over. It's still not fully show. Yeah. Alright, that's what it look like then now. Mm-hmm. Okay. Start over again, dog. Hello, beautiful people. Man, I said this the first time. What did you say again? Happy Sunday to you, beautiful people. And here we go. I give to you Reverend, should I say Babylon, or Reverend Policeman, or Reverend Officer, Reverend Sergeant.
But it can't buy time, money, can't buy your house, but it can't buy a home. Somebody worship God, it's my soul. Hallelujah. Let me take you into the hospital. Because money can buy blood, but it can't buy life. Money, my brothers and sisters, is the root of all evil. But money answereth all things. Can I preach in Spanish tongue? Whether you like it or you dislike it, I come to preach. And there's no devil in hell gonna stop me. Somebody shout yes!
Yes! Yes!
Almighty, I feel my head pulling. I feel the Holy Ghost. Down inside of me, telling me to go on. My God shall supply all your needs. Ah, good God, that is strong. Hello, I tell you, there are some people that think that because you're a Christian, you're not supposed to carry gun. Let me link it for you. Let me take you back down into Samuel's. When David got his gun, and David said, Hey, Goliath, who are you?
Hey, Hallelujah!
He's a man of God's own heart, and yet still, he went down to the street and find five stones. Javelin, but I come.
Hallelujah!
In the name, not police name. Hello, somebody.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Demons are to flee. Hello, gunman. Don't you play with God. God want rough. I'm here to tell somebody that salvation is at your door. Examine
knocking
your steps to your door. Lock down your steps. Examine your steps and see if salvation is really at your door.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
For the police celebrating 150 years. Hallelujah! And that's why we are here on tonight. To tell somebody that Jesus is alive. So we take it down there in the scriptures. And the Bible said this man was very rich. Praise God. But he did not allow his riches to stop him. Anytime you want to become a Christian, anytime you want.
Happy Sunday, people. Happy Sunday. Happy Sunday. Happy Sunday. Look well now. Men are going to say. Uncle Hope, you have no gun upon him as a Christian police, you now walk with gun. Me and if I read, you read me mind, you know. But I see him tell me and jump out. If some people feel say, Christian, nothing walk with the old lion, Rere, rete, nantete. Me no bada see a word. Well, I know, I like the nice vibes. I mean, the nice Christmas spirit in it. Christmas spirit, you know? The nice Sunday spirit, the nice Christian spirit in it. You know, the Sunday and the little vibes. And if you come from a policeman that me like that, at least you know, if you buck a youth on the road and you would do the best to care me before you shoot him, you understand? Because probably, although the guy said, thou shall not kill, but the guys have one scripture in the Bible where say, if you kill, so. I'm going to leave it there, so I'm just making Steve as a nice overall performance. I like it. Peeps, big up on yourself and don't forget to subscribe to my new YouTube channel, Rapper Crapper Vlog, to have no access to my original one. So subscribe to the new one. And have a beautiful Sunday. Me enjoy the video, yeah.
Greetings, my people. Turbo next year. This is going to be the most important video I've ever done on my Facebook page, because it contains classified important information that people, not just in Jamaica but mainly Jamaica, around the world, most people, some people are aware of it, some don't. It is called organ harvesting. Those of whom of us who are living abroad may be a little bit more familiar, but for the Jamaican people, they don't, the most of them will not know what it is. And because the culprits who are financing this heinous act against the Jamaican people know this, they made it seems like it is an abduction and rape. But what draw my attention to do this is a girl, a body was sent to me, a picture of a body of a young girl in a building that was, her neck was cut and her throat and her chest area was bloodied. I could not see, according to the body, if her chest was cut. But the problem is her pants was on, and she had her jeans pants on. It didn't look, nobody touch her pants. So me, I say to myself, they're not gonna rape this. That's what draw my attention. I tried twice on Facebook to go live with this. I put it up once when it was just a suspicion, and Facebook quickly took it down. I tried again, they would not let me connect live. So that's why I choose this route. Now, my people, organ harvesting is big money upon the black market. Now, Jamaican people enough to know this. Even though a Jamaicans are carry out the act on their own people, it is bigger than Jamaicans. Why? Because one human being is worth at least $1 million dead. So you're worth more dead than being alive. Let me explain this. One heart is about $200,000 to $300,000. One liver can run anywhere from $200,000 to $500,000. Not to mention the kidneys and the other parts. Okay? The news out of Jamaica is that the police went in on a group of guys, got lead and went into a group of guys, killed one of the guys, and the rest begin to speak. It is a organized thing, and it spread throughout Jamaica, and that is why I was wondering why girls are being killed throughout Jamaica. Now, why young girls? It's because they are more vulnerable. Why young? Because their heart, their organs are valued more. Right? If you notice, no old people, no men, no boys. Boys will put up a bigger fight than a girl would, because girls are more naive. They know that. Now, so go back to this is not a is not, even though it's the men from Jamaica are doing this because they are paid to do it, it is an outsider work. Now, if one person worth $1 million dead, no Jamaican, me know my Jamaican people them, is gonna fund it. And number one, Jamaican people, majority of Jamaican people are poor and they will not find that money. Now, one person, you know, worth $1 million dead. It is an outside job. It is a foreign country that is targeting Jamaica because them see it as a third world country. Son of a bitches. You understand me? I hope you guys share this fast before them delete it. And if them delete me, I'm going to post it again. I'm going to also send this video on WhatsApp. I am telling you people, these killings are, and I knew it, that it is organ harvesting. Now, so my word to the people them in Jamaica. Young girls, stop walk alone. People on a go out in groups. Fathers, go out, meet your daughters, meet your sons. Mothers, do the same. Community, come together. If there is anything suspicious going on that you know is not right, report it. Organ harvesting. It is not the end of it. Because these foreign people gonna keep on pouring the money into Jamaica because it is a big, big, big industry, not in Jamaica. It is elsewhere into foreign countries like Colombia, the US, and other countries. Now, let me get it straight and tell you now. Hear me? Go and Google this information. Go and look it up. So, Jamaican people, if you think so because you don't get killed yet and you're not going to be a statistics one day, play stupid. Because when a man look at you, he sees a 500,000 or $1 million. So to you, he might smile and you think he's genuine. But all him see are some dollars. And let me tell you something, Marcus Garvey said when the man back is against the wall, he would do anything. When desperation set in. Now, this kind of act will cause a man to kidnap his own picnic, his own family, and sell them. These things have been going on around the world for a while now. And people have been catching on to them. And not only that, the market increases. Now, let me tell you now. Who are buying these arts? You think, when these organs, you think, do you think it's poor people? Poor people can't buy heart. They can't buy organ because they're not even in America. You understand me? It's big celebrities, doctors and lawyers and money people, pioneers who are funding these things. Because when a Hollywood man wants an organ that they claim is important to him, he will spend big money for a child to be killed to get that heart or that organ or that liver or that kidney. So me are telling the Jamaican people, who no wise up and unite. If you never unite before, now is the time to unite. Jamaica is a place of community. We bring back the community love and each one teach one and look out for the other. My brothers, if you see a sister coming home late from work one night, walk with her. Protect her. See? On a walk together in a group, I'm gonna emphasize it again. Walk together in groups. If on a protect each other, Virgin, me don't know how else to say it. On a protect each other, it is deadly. The police, this is bigger than the police, and the police cannot stop this right now. It's gonna take a collaborative effort of the community to stop this. Okay, do not rely on the government. Do not rely on the police alone. You have to come together and protect one another because this money is going to keep on pouring in Jamaica until gonna come together. Okay? So if the money still a come in, a man see the money, and him realize him can't catch no more young girl for kill him, I go start catching young boys. And when he can't catch young boys, he going to start catch anybody at all they can catch, because they are desperate for the money. For it is written that money is the root of all evil. Rastafari, the word of Jah is coming to pass. Money is the root of all evil. You can't kill as much of these guys as you want to, but they will keep coming back, because the money is there to fund this operation. US dollars are there, or England pound, or wherever. It is not Jamaican dollar. Jamaican dollar not have no value for do this king. Me a want you know. Me a want you know. Take it from Turbanex. Me a want you know. And me no give a shit. Come here, some official. Me no official I go come in pan this. You hear me? Me no afraid of nobody. I'm going to talk. You see me? Me want my people them wise up. This is crazy. Me love you know. Share that video you fast. You know, go Google it fast. You know, go read up and teach mamas, papas, call on the children and make them know how important it is. It is not rape. It is not lovers quarrel. They are told to make it look like a rape, because they want to confuse you guys and make you think, oh, then just rape that girl. No. Why would a man rape a girl and cut her head off, cut her hand off, cut her foot off, cut off her body, and no, brethren, them things they no go on. When a rape victim is being killed, she's killed to be silent, and once she's dead, the culprit got walk gone, because there's no evidence against him in the court. But he's not going to spend the time to take this person and cut her to pieces. Why, King, would have asking yourself these questions? Ask why. When something happened, don't just flare up and get mad. Start ask questions. Why? Okay, why? How this do? And the Jamaican people them and police them down there is really, this is really crazy. I wouldn't have seen this long time, Virgin. And I met the people them know this. Eh? Wanna start put out billboards and put it on the TV, so we walk together in a group and people, if you see anybody that is stranded, trust me, if it means you go and take out on a way, if you take that person home, do it, because you go and save another life. Me love you no, me give you the information, can't say me never tell you no. Love you no, very much. Peace.
The struggle is real, people. Organ harvesting, organ trafficking, we know say boy, that real. We know say something real. You understand, a lot of country been suffering from that, not now, but from way back when. You see me, Africa, a couple more Caribbean. You see me, because we say, when it comes to organs, now big money for it now. However, when it comes to Jamaica, at this moment, everything else will go on from the other day. I haven't received no video or no footage when them find them body were dead. I don't have no organs. Me even mention, say, in my last blog video with the youth Itira Chicken, say more time, it's some people dead and then I no organ, and them then niam out the organ. You see me, but even me saying that, as me say, a long time I couldn't tell when me ever receive a photo or a video. Or them say people don't have no organs still. But there's a message during in the message. Cause I say a lot of people are come a laugh and a complain and I say much at fuck and watch at shit. Sometimes people you have to listen. Cause sometimes things that you feel say are nonsense, there's a lot of sense in there at the same time. Probably a person might not deliver a story straight. Story might jumble up or mix up, so you might see a puzzle and you can't put it together. But there is a puzzle. So people are telling them more time who phone the jump and say right and they need to listen. You see me? But the next, and most of the youth them now in Jamaica to do organ harvesting. If you say the man go have the appropriate tool or the appropriate thing, oh, if you keep it. You see me? Because you're not just like sitting, can just go in and cut out the organ and just touch it for ice alone. Mm-mm. One or two things else you have to do, I think you're dead. But as for the overall thing, as me as the people, We have to TSC, try to stay safe. We have to look out our eyes and we have to help each other. That's all I have to say. I have not more to say more than to say struggle is real. Listen, you understand, pick sense out of nonsense. You see me? And even the story where I said the police running and kill one. I saw the next story as well, where them said the police kill one somewhere and then go up on the next ends and go take a couple of them out of the house and then them do it talking. So as I tell you how story them go out and they never walk straight. But there's a story sometime. Big sense out of nonsense. Struggle is real.
Good morning. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. I'm in my bed in Florida, just sitting down. I've been reading my Bible and just giving God praise, you know, giving Him thanks and just honoring Him for sparing my life. I've seen God hands on my life many times. A lot of us have been through a lot of things. As I told you all, I've been a victim of rape and wasn't one, two, or three times in Jamaica. It was several times. A lot of us allow pride to not talk about what have happened to us as teenagers growing up. I grew up in Maxfield Avenue. You know, I spent a part of my life there. I was born in Galena, St. Mary. I went to Kingston. Simply because my mom and dad, you know, used to fight a lot. And because of that, my mom would run away to Kingston. And our dad took us there. And we were back and forth from there. The first day, I end up in a place called Freeman Lane. I remember I kicked a ball. Because at the time, I liked playing ball and like, you know, making carts and them things like town boy. And I remember I kicked a ball over a zinc fence. And when I went to get it, a man hold on to me and said, "Jenny, daughter, this, you're pretty man. You're brown and you're browning." And I scream out, and that was when he let go of my hand. Now I'm here. You see, I'm gonna pluck up my head, man. Right now I have nothing to hide. And we need to rise up in Jamaica. We need to rise up as women. I've been so mad, you know, I got a message on via WhatsApp some weeks ago, and it just cut my heart. I mean, I don't have kids, I don't have children, but as you know, I adopt a few, you know, and I am so hurt. I'm so hurt and mad about what's been going on in Jamaica. Come on now, I'm a survivor of rape several times, and I even use the same sex to make myself famous as Lady Saw, simply because I wanted to get my family out of the ghettos. And people thought, oh, she's a sex goddess. You know, yes, man, she loves sex. No, I was saying what you all wanted me to say, because that was what I thought sell at the time. But let me tell you something, man, in a Jamaica. Come on now, I wish woman push you out. Come on now, me's a Christian woman, but me a geared raw. Me's a radical Christian no man. Come on. Wow, uno fi a do uno own daughter them, uno own stink bow no mother, uno sister. Come on now. Who gave birth to man like uno? Eh? Come on, have you ever thought of, Are you on drugs? Oh my God, your mother bring you for 9 months in her womb, in her gut. And you're going to tell me, say, you're going to kill off, you're going to rape and kill? Come on, me is a victim of rape. I can't have children, not on my own. Yeah, I got pregnant several times, but guess what? IVF. Because what? Because of what you did to me. Men like Uno do to me back in the days. It made me have such a hard time. It was such a hard task to get pregnant naturally. Because you robbed me of that. You robbed me of that. But now you're taking our lives. You're taking our lives. Listen, just watching a man disrespect a woman not sit well with me. And you're telling me that you're raping your own daughters. Because I know, you know, say, uno have picnic, you know, somehow uno have picnic, you know, somehow uno have daughter and say, oh, my love my daughter, and if a boy touch my daughter, Oh, gunshot! But then you're doing that to another mother, another child. You're robbing them of their innocence. You're robbing them. You take away them life. What is wrong with you? Don't you think there's a God? Don't you know there is a God? We are a God-fearing country. We grew up knowing that God exists. And when we have problems and with tribulation, we go upon our knees. What wrong with you? No? What wrong with you? No? Come on, rise up now, Lisa Anna. Come on. Rise up, Portia Simpson. Come on. Come on, women, powerful women, we need to fight, we need to march, we need to rebel. Come on, come rebel against them, man. Call them, man, animal. Why? These men couldn't be normal men. I remember I was set up by a friend one time. You know, there was a guy who I liked by the name of Dean. And he liked me, and I thought that was my little boyfriend. You know, my friend, I was waiting on my girlfriend, John. I was waiting on her at her boyfriend place, you know, in the ghetto. And I remember she come and she and her boyfriend come and she keep telling me that Dean called me down the road. I say, I'm not going down there, so, you know, bad place. She keep insisting that Dean called me. And after a while, I thought she need privacy, so I walk go down there. No, it was not like that. It was a setup. My own friend, you see, uno woman, we are set up uno friend, uno fi face it, you know, uno fi face it. You know something? When you think about the Bible and the Moses law, you remember the Moses law them? You remember even David? David sometime in a prayer, pretty prayer, you know, fi enemy them. And you know, it's like an eye for an eye, you know. You understand? It's like David law. It's like we need to go back there.
I know me tell you struggle is real. People now hear me. My master, I say, you me I say, as me I say, now I time me now. Ladies, you know, if you step out there and hold up on your head. You understand? Me attack the ladies, them a role model. You understand? You know, if you step out there and push up on your head and make people know so watching on the tide of what I go on, you know. You understand? Ladies, them a role mother, who sister them, you know. You understand? Nieces, you know. Granddaughters, you know, so we have to love them and look after them, you know. Big up yourself, ladies, sir. You understand? Because we know, so in time like in this, we appreciate if you see us step up and you understand, you even give us a little insight of our life and make we know, say, struggle really real. You see me? And I talk to them, blow all. Me don't even know what to call them out there. Me don't even know what to call them. John, no start. I mean, I say I love and respect on people. The struggle is real.